All right, after nearly half a decade of flirting with the Indian real estate market, private equity funds seem to have finally decided to take the plunge. Private equity inflows into real estate have increased to reach their highest levels since the first half of 2009. What's driving this resurgence and is it back for good? Nikhil Narayan Sividas has this report.
Low demand, uncertainty and long gestation periods have so far kept private equity funds away from all but the largest developers in Indian real estate. But that trend seems to be changing and private equity interest in real estate is returning. Sunil Rohakale of ASK Investment Managers is a perfect example of this. A veteran private equity investor, he has launched a 1,500 crore rupee domestic fund and is in the process of raising a $200 million offshore fund to take advantage of a resurgence in investor sentiment.
The actions taken by the new government and now the stability of rupee actually made the international investors to think, which otherwise was a written-off story for India real estate, is coming back.
The numbers reflect that confidence. Data from Cushman & Wakefield indicates that nearly 4,100 crores of PE inflows into the real estate space were seen in the first half of 2014. That's more than double the 1,650 crores that came in 2013 and the highest since nearly 4,950 crores were invested in 2009. A large part of this rising interest is of course due to the government's moves on REITs. But that's not to say that residential is being ignored. On the contrary, residential remains a safe bet for PE investors who consider it to be the only vertical to remain unaffected by market dynamics.
Immune to market dynamics because the Indian resident, typically a professional that will buy this kind of a house, is a risk-averse individual and is unlikely to default on their first house purchase.
I would expect affordable housing to be the pick of private equity investors going forward. In addition to that, I think when we talk about affordability, the world over, there is a huge housing shortfall, but at the same time, there are issues in terms of affordability. So rental housing is going to pick up.
The lack of capital and the almost perpetually cash-starved nature of Indian real estate has resulted in PE funds finding unique distress opportunities to invest in. One such tactic being used is the inventory buyout fund.
There is some initiatives by private equity firms where they see that they can actually buy a ready inventory of apartments from various developers at a discount of 25 to 30%. As they expect the markets to turn around next year, maybe by second half of next year, they would get an opportunity to exit and make and book this profit of 25-30%.
PE funds have also changed tactic. Where earlier most funds were built around long deployment times, funds today have shorter cycles and very definite expectations on returns. So are the good times back for private equity investments in real estate? Experts say it might be, provided that investors get a chance to see quantifiable returns.
My sense is that next 2 to 3 years' time, at least $5 to $10 billion should find the way home back to the investors.
So will PE investors see these kind of returns and will this trend remain for good? That's a question only time can tell. In the meantime, the Indian real estate sector can console itself with the fact that capital is flowing into it once again. From Mumbai, Nikhil Narayan Sivadas, NDTV.